Do you have a confession to make?
I was hoping that you could say a prayer for a woman who was murdered. Her name was Dolores Barrett. Her killers were caught tonight, but her family won't get to see it. According to the internet, her mother, Linda, died last week. Linda never stopped trying to find out what happened to Dolores. Ignored by the police, she found someone to advocate for her. Someone who found Dolores' missing earring in 2013. Someone who administered chaplain services to the jail and the police department back then, someone who still does. On the phone tonight, I heard the faintest ringing sound.
Tonight, I am the Arbitur. Someone here knows what happened to Dolores Barrett.
Church bells ringing on the hour. So the same question goes for you, Reverend. Do you have a confession to make?
How long do I have before the authorities arrive?
I didn't tell them about you.
In 2013, after they published Dolores' photo, I realized it was her earring I found that morning in the holding cell. And when I asked them about it, they insisted someone else had claimed the earring, but I knew in my heart that wasn't true. I could tell they had done something to her. For years, I prayed for justice. And then Dolores' mother died last week, and I decided to make that justice happen myself. But I needed to make sure they would confess. And for that to happen, I needed pressure. When I heard Tamura and the DA discussing your arrest warrant, I finally had my chance. I was a mechanical engineer before I went to the seminary, so rigging up the water and electrical was simple. Still, I'm sorry Tamura's hurt.
Tomorrow's gonna be okay.
Oh, good.
He's just about to head into surgery soon.
I read you recounted your testimony against Everett Hudson. Doesn't seem like you.
I don't know who I am anymore.
Matthew 7. Every good tree bringeth forth good fruit, but a corrupt tree bringeth forth evil fruit. One's choices tell the world who they are. What will yours say about you?